Hi guys, I just wanted to make a video on how to load your Hyaluron Pen, because when I studied and first started, I know it can be a little confusing and there's not many precise, clear videos. So I want to try and help you understand. So here's your pen. I'm just going to get right into it. It's basically amped by pressure. So when you do this and push this button, that creates the pressure. So how you're gonna start is you're gonna need these needleless syringes. You can order them online. They have them on Amazon, but it's bigger price. You can get them more on like Alibaba if you order them like in bulk, and they're lower cost. So they should cost, like, if you get them on Alibaba, around $1.50. If you get them on Amazon, it could be anywhere between $4 and $5 per needle. This pen holds 5 milliliters. Some only hold 3 milliliters. I prefer the 5 because most people want at least a milliliter of hyaluronic acid. I'm using water right now as an example. So what you're going to do is you're going to fill up your syringe. I usually, I don't know if you can see, but I usually fill like 4 milliliters because there's still some space where this little thing needs to move up. So I just fill it up. And then when you push this white up, hold on, I need a little more pressure. You're going to see some of the fluid coming out. I don't know if you can see it, but you see it? And then you're going to put it up to the 0.5 mark. Then you're gonna take your pen. You're gonna make sure that it's not pressurized. So push the button, make sure that it doesn't click. Once it doesn't click, you're gonna open all the way till it doesn't stop. And you're gonna put your needleless in. You have to make sure, like I said, that this little white stick is at the 5, because if not, it won't fit in your pen. If it doesn't fit, then that means you need to push out a little bit more liquid. Okay, so you're gonna tighten your needleless needle. Obviously, you're gonna be wearing gloves too. I'm just showing you, and this is just water. Just saying. Then, once you're ready to start, you're gonna get the pressure going by opening this. You're gonna hear a click. And here are your numbers. So there's about 1 milliliter that you can fit in this whole thing. I'm sorry, a half a milliliter. So 0.12345, half a milliliter. 1 milliliter is 2. You get what I'm saying. So let's say you're doing the lips. In some cases, some people might need maybe 1.1 here. You might want to do 0.2 here. Everybody's different. Everybody's lips are different. So you're going to just have to practice and you'll learn how much to put per client. It's all in trial and error. You have to practice. So there's no like set number. I can't tell you a set number. I personally just did it the other day. I don't like huge lips. So I only put 0.1, 0.1, 0.1, 0.1, 0.1, 0.1. I didn't put it in the middle because I like the little heart shape. I like it completely natural. For somebody that wants like a bigger upper lip, then you'd put more, you'd put 2 or 3. You just kind of, it's actually kind of an easy thing. You can keep building. Try 0.1. If it's not enough, try 0.2. If it's not enough, keep going. All right, so now you have this here and you've already pressurized this. You're going to move down to the amount that you want. So let's say we're doing 0.1. Oops. We're going to go to the 1. And remember, this is already pressurized, so you are ready to go right now. You're going to turn this up. You're going to find an area. You have to make sure that you push, you have good pressure. Once you have good pressure, and watch your angle, because remember, wherever your angle is where it's gonna shoot out. So If you're going from the upper lip, you want to go down, not, you know, not necessarily up. When you're going in the bottom lip, you're going to go more up. So you're going to find a good spot. When you find a good spot, you're going to hit the button. I'm not going to do it right now because it's just water. And you see the water shoot out? Then you go again. Pressurize it. And go to your two. Again, find your spot and push. Make sure your pressure is good, because if your pressure is not good, obviously it's not gonna go out. You're gonna see the product just kind of spill over the over the area. That means you didn't get it in. Also, another sign is usually you'll have pinpoint bleeding. To me, it's a good sign that it went in. So when I see pinpoint bleeding, I know it went in. So I look for that. Does pinpoint bleeding always happen? Not necessarily, but most of the time, yes. And that's pretty much it. It's an awesome treatment. It's great for anyone who's scared of needles, who doesn't like needles, or who wants like a more gentler approach to fillers. You can also do it on the nasolabial fold. I actually just did mine today. They're still a little bit red. You can't see them, but they're filling up. I probably need more, but I was in a rush, so I only did like two. I tend to stay away from this area. I think if you go to somebody who knows what they're doing, then you can do it. But just keep in mind that there's bone there, and you know, just to be careful, be safe, and make sure you're going to somebody who is certified, who knows what they're doing, who's done this before, has a portfolio. You can see before and after photos. And yeah, I'll keep posting some videos. I just started offering this in our office. You can check us out on Instagram. It's at Feel the Heal. That's F as in Frank, E-E-L-T-H-E-H-E-A-L. I'll put it in the caption. And you can see all my work. And if you have any questions, feel free to drop a question. And I will help you out the best I can. I know I needed help when I first started, but as you keep practicing and keep watching videos and keep learning, don't stop learning, don't stop taking tips and asking questions, and it becomes easier. Hope you enjoy. Thanks. Bye.